The New Space Race. The USA vs. China vs. Russia. Unknown to many of us, there is a colossal tussle for supremacy among the stars. Glance into the skies, and there you will discover humanity's massive geopolitical superpowers battling one another for control. Nonetheless, this time around, unlike what was experienced in the 60s, there are about three of them. Or are there more? It's very complex to comprehend. Hello guys, welcome back to your favorite YouTube channel. Right before we delve into the video for today, please take out some time to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click on the bell button to get a notification of all our latest videos. Come along with us as we survey the new space race going on currently between the three most prominent countries in the world. The space race actually started way back in the 1950s. Preferably, these events were referred to as either classic or old-fashioned space races. This race peaked back in the 1960s and sprung further by the mid-70s. Back in the days, this was an unofficial race. No one bothered to wave a green flag to set things off or cheer the winning team. However, the two largest technological and economic powers of our time, the Soviet Union and the United States, battled endlessly to be the first to make rather impressive progress into the cosmos. We should give it to them. The race achievement, no doubt, may not be phenomenal feats like getting humans into orbit, but it was nonetheless legendary. Remarkably, they did have phenomenal feats when they first got humans into orbit, achieved by the Soviets. Interestingly, the first footprint found on the moon was put right there by the Americans. The United States, in their own right, made amazing logistical and technical accomplishments. And, as expected, these landmark actions signified prestige and power dominance. However, it is really important to note that these actions were deliberate. They were intentionally carried out to display the effectiveness of each strength in the economy and also their distinct system of government. On the side of the Soviet Union, it was broadly communism, and for the United States, it is liberal democratic capitalism. Actually, it may have been the desire to prove not only their ideological, but also their technical dominance over their rivalries that drove these sides to their fantastic heights. Now, in this current era, let's take a quick look at who's participating in the space race for 2021. We will also cross-check if this is even a race and the most remarkable difference between the old-school space race and our contemporary race. Another look in the direction of China. The race right in the People's Republic is no doubt a superpower in terrestrial terms. Yet, this country only got their first astronaut into orbit in 2003. Sadly, with the Chinese government, you never can tell the exact figures on investment, and this is due to their secretive nature. Nevertheless, it is a known fact by the experts in the field of giving that the Chinese spend about a quarter of what the United States budgets for space explorations. Surprisingly, even with a slim budget, China is doing an incredible job in the space race. The Chinese satellite navigational system called Beidou Navigation Satellite System, BDS, and also known as Compass or Beidou 2, is actually the main rival to the United States satellite. Just late summer, their final beta satellite was put into orbit, thus making the entire array fully operational. Not everyone knows how huge the independence of the Beidou satellite from the American system is to the People's Republic. Actually, it matters a whole lot to these people since the independence didn't really end with the space race. It also enables the People's Republic to be independent in everything from fast food delivery navigation down to missile launches. As a part of the Chinese's expansionist Road and Belt initiative, various nations like Pakistan and Brunei are currently going with Beidou instead of GPS. Now this is a clear illustration of modern imperialism in action. Not only are countries going with what China has to offer, but experts also say that Beidou offers 20 centimeters more accuracy than GPS, which is used for both civil and military applications. Astonishingly, China is also known for carrying out more than its share of grandstanding space missions in 2019. This they achieved by placing a rover on the dark side of the moon, an action that NASA praised endlessly as the first for humanity and also rated as an impressive accomplishment on China's part. Remarkably still, China's recent mission to orbit currently returned to Earth with rock samples, something that is yet to be accomplished by any space explorations since the 1970s. Studies confirm that China is currently in the process of assembling its own orbital space station, which they called Tiangong 3, or the Heavenly Palace. About 10 years ago, the United States Congress stopped the Chinese government from having any involvement in the ISS. In reaction to this, during the course of 11 missions scheduled over the next 2 years, China will build its own, and it will certainly do better than ISS. No need to argue, because the rate at which China is attacking these things, whatever they tend to build, will last longer, since ISS will likely be retired in the next decade or so. There is no stopping China. Their ambition also extends further out into the solar system. Now, when NASA's Perseverance rover landed on Mars, it made headlines all over the world since it was a big deal getting a robot safely onto the red planet. However, what was not announced at that time was the fact that a Chinese mission with its own rover, Tianwen-1, aka Quest for Heavenly Truth, also arrived on the red planet at the same time as the Perseverance rover. As we speak, right this minute, the Chinese rover is currently in a so-called parking orbit around the red planet. In order to support this rover's mission, China has been busily upgrading its earthbound monitoring stations in the far western Xinjiang region and the northeast and Heilongjiang province. Interestingly, key infrastructure that will prove invaluable to future space missions is already in place as well. There is so much more that China is presently planning. As rumor has it, they are planning a Voyager-style probe mission to be launched out into the more distant solar system under the working title IHP, or Interstellar Heliosphere Probe. The mission will dispatch two space probes to investigate the vast electrically charged gas bubble which surrounds our solar system and fluctuates as we travel through the galaxy. One of the IHP probes will also use not one, but two flybys of Earth and one of Jupiter in order to pick up speed, and it is expected to reach the heliosphere in the year 2049. Its counterpart probe is due to move into the cold, distant Neptune around 2038. Just in case you still think America has the monopoly on buccaneering private sector rocketeers like Elon Musk, think again. Chinese tech billionaire Lei Jun is an enthusiastic investor in Galaxy Space. Lei is actually one out of many various independent operators working in the country Galaxy Space. He already runs China's first low Earth orbit 5G satellite system and is presently building its own gigafactory in Jiangsu province, in order to build and launch hundreds of satellites to rival Elon Musk's Starlink internet scheme. That's not all. Another private Chinese firm in the fray is iSpace, which currently has raised billions in startup capital and, among other attention-grabbing exploits, is planning to develop a reusable space plane to service the nascent orbital tourism market despite all that frantic activity. Nevertheless, even with all these achievements, many Chinese analysts have accepted the view that the People's Republic is in no mood to race in space with the rest of the competitors. It's also argued that China is merely playing catch-up for now. No doubt, space science has value, but a good number of analysts believe that China is only operating in order to mount a convincing deterrent. Guaranteed, there's some propaganda value to these big projects, and Chinese tourists indeed flock to tropical Hainan Island to observe the launch of the country's pride and joy, Long March 5B spacecraft. Notwithstanding how impressive the country's rover technology is, there is no secret that it lags decades behind the United States rover technology. Nonetheless, an average American argues that since the space shuttle program was shut down in 2011, the country is yet to capture the world's imagination with anything truly groundbreaking in the field of space travel. Well, that was the case until recently. NASA relied on Russian spacecraft to transport people and supplies to the ISS. Thanks to Elon Musk, SpaceX, and its ambitious program of Starship development, most of the recent accomplishments wouldn't have been achieved. Yet, that's not really the whole story. Currently, there is the Artemis program, a NASA-led initiative that plans to put the first woman on the moon by 2021. Not only this, but Artemis is also looking forward to preparing the moon for future resource development and establishment, since it is a stepping stone to Mars. On the way to revitalizing the Artemis project, NASA is developing its first deep space rocket since Saturn V. It is also planning the not really important task of putting a space station around the moon known as the Gateway Project. Incidentally, SpaceX already has the contract to run supply missions to and from the Gateway, while NASA's Perseverance rover is just getting started on its quest to seek out life and prepare for future crewed missions to Mars. On Russia's venture, unfortunately, Russia's high-profile joint venture with China hoping to get a rover to Mars some years ago failed on the launch pad despite a hardening and terrestrial relations between Russia and America during recent years over issues from the conflict in Syria to the US election interference. The two nations have collaborated amicably when it comes to space. Nevertheless, a newly energized NASA spurred on by the Trump budget increase and Russian space supremo Dmitry Rogozin's griping over the Artemis records suggest a cooling off. Russia is barely in the race these days with a non-committal government and economic problems of its own to overcome. But even if there isn't a race per se, the technologies that are being developed to drive the next wave of exploration should energize everybody, whether or not one nation succeeds in eclipsing the other. That's it on the new space race, the US versus China versus Russia. So, what do you think? Is the competition going to bring about real progress? What upcoming missions are you most excited about? Let us know your impressions and views in the comment section below.